carbohydrate. The next nutrient is protein. Yes, there is slightly increased protein requirement for sports people when compared to a normal person. But when it comes to the fat intake, does not change between a common man and a person who is actively involved in sports. So in short, if I have to tell you about the diet for a person who is actively involved in sports, is a well-balanced diet, a varied diet with increased amount of fluid and calories to meet the increased requirements. Starting off with carbohydrates, alright, as I told you that it is the most preferred fuel. It gives you the energy while you are performing your event. So you tell me, what are carbohydrates and what are the sources of carbohydrates? You have any idea about carbohydrates? Have you read in your biology classes? Yes. Yes. When you talk about carbohydrates, principally they are starches and sugars. Alright. Have you heard about the process of photosynthesis? Yes. Yes. Carbohydrates are principally found in these green plants. By the process of photosynthesis, they utilize sunlight, they utilize air, they utilize water to prepare what is called as carbohydrate. It is either in form of fruit, that is the sugar, example is different colors of fruits. You have starches, as you already mentioned that cereals, cereal grains like jowar or wheat or bajra. Then you have peas, then you have beans. Have you heard about root and tuber vegetables? Could you name them? Root and tuber vegetables. Yes, beetroot, carrot, potato. Yes, these are a good source of carbohydrates. And as a dietitian, I would recommend complex carbohydrates. When I say complex carbohydrates, it means the starchy foods. Why these are more preferred than simple sugars? Because they are broken down in your body very slowly. They are absorbed very slowly. And starches have an advantage because it is readily converted into glycogen. And glycogen is the major fuel, all right, during exercise. Simple sugars, the sugar that you add in your tea and coffee is not really preferable. Why? Because it is not readily converted into glycogen, which is very important. And secondly, excess amount of simple sugars, the sugar in soft drinks or jams or jellies, or the sugar that you add to your tea and coffee, will easily get converted into